Let's start with the Pittsburgh Penguins. Not good news. Bjugstad and Malkin out, and it doesn't sound like these are short-term injuries. What do you know?
Well, you know, I know basically what Pittsburgh said today. As you mentioned, these are not short-term injuries. Malkin longer than Bjugstad. I think the concern with Malkin in particular is that it's being reported as a soft tissue injury. And just from what I've been trying to work on today, sometimes when you have that kind of an injury, and Kevin and Dave is actual ex-athletes will know this, sometimes you don't know until you get in there and you kind of see what exactly is going on. So one of the reasons I think Pittsburgh is being careful about giving a timeline is not because they're trying to hide anything, but because they may not know yet. And hopefully it's not the worst case scenario, but I can certainly see a sense here of they're not sure what it's going to be, and they're hoping it's not as long as it could potentially be.
Our crew is amazing. The stats they just threw up with and without Gino, amazing that the winning percentage, the points percentage, this is remarkable. I was going to cue Bono with or without you, but at this point, if I'm a Pens fan, I'm not freaking out, and I'm not going to the YouTube playlist. I am going to the second question. Dustin Byfuglien, one of the more intriguing storylines of the offseason. We know that he is not playing, and there's a lot of intrigue surrounding his current situation. What do you know about Big Buff?
Well, Tony, on Friday, I went on our local radio station here in Toronto, The Fan, and they asked me what I was hearing, and I said, I'm hearing the same thing I heard at the beginning of the season, which is they're going to have to talk him out of retiring. And his agent, I spoke to him, Ben Hankinson, on Saturday, and he said, look, don't assume anything. And, you know, he said that that is the thing you have to be aware of, is that this is going to take some time. There's not going to be a quick resolution, so nobody should jump to any assumptions. I think what the Jets are clearly hoping is that he will be turn on the game, see that they are going on, and be bitten by the bug, and maybe that the team is struggling defensively, he can come back and help. But even if that's the case, I don't expect it to be in the near future. So we're in kind of a holding pattern here. So are the Jets. The tough thing for them is that, you know, they're tight to the cap, and if Byfuglien does come back, they have to be extremely careful of what they do with their money that they allocate. Now, I do think that they have looked for defensemen around the league. I think they worried on Joel Edmondson. I've heard, you know, Detroit has a lot of D that maybe they're looking around there, but because of the whole Byfuglien thing, I think it complicates what they can and can't do.
The Byfuglien situation is one that's being monitored throughout the National Hockey League by all the teams. Another thing that has created buzz league-wide, the Braden Schenn deal. What's the reaction there, and does this mean that Alex Pietrangelo is next?
Well, I think people are really happy for Braden Schenn. Whenever a player gets an eight-year deal, as especially as they head into their 30s, like they're here, and I saw him at the skate this morning, and you know, he was well aware that if he went, first of all, he wanted to be in St. Louis. And an old saying I really believe in is don't fool around with happy. Although I wasn't told it exactly in those words, I'd like to keep this job, so I'm not going to repeat exactly what I was told. Don't fool around with happy. Braden Schenn is happy. He just won a Stanley Cup. Why wouldn't he want to stay in St. Louis? And he's well aware there's a guy who's approaching 30. He wasn't likely getting 8 years anywhere else. So I think he's happy and people are happy for him. Pietrangelo, his agents are based here. And I don't know, Tony, if you guys have any access to the media scrum with him this morning. He's a really friendly player to deal with. When he stands in front of his stalls and talks, he's very good to talk to. The one time he clammed up and you could sense his mood change was when he was asked about his contract this morning. And he said, look, I just want to focus on hockey. I don't want to talk about it. So I think this one has been a little more difficult than everybody expected. We believe his agent is meeting with his agents who are at Newport based in Toronto, met with the Blues today. I mean, we'll see. I think they want him at Oliver Ekman-Larsson, which is 8.25 over 8 or thereabouts. If he goes to market, he's going to get more than that. So I think there's some work that has to be done here.
I'll echo your sentiments on the professionalism of 27. Throughout that cup final, he was so professional. An absolute pleasure to deal with. Last thing for you, Mark Pisick, Panthers, possibly on the move. Is that the news that we are hearing?
You know, he's not the biggest name, Tony, but he is a pretty serviceable, solid NHL defenseman. He did not play the first two games for Florida today. Joel Quenneville said he's likely going to get in the lineup tomorrow night. He's a free agent after this season. He's a, like I said, he's not like a number one, but he's a solid D. There are teams looking for defensemen in this league. I can see this as a bit of a showcase. I mentioned Winnipeg earlier. New Jersey had looked at him. Vancouver in the summer had looked at him. I think he's a guy the Panthers are looking to move. And the fact he's in the lineup tomorrow night, I think you'll see some teams look at him.